As with most tech gadgets, surveillance cameras are becoming smarter and smarter. They used to just simply record what's happening, but now some of them can prevent accidents and even catch intruders. Our Kim Ji-yeon has this story.
An employee starts to walk around with no safety mask or safety gear on. The potentially hazardous situation is detected by a state-of-the-art camera and instantly relayed to a safety administrator. This smart video management system, or SVMS, developed by Samsung S1, has the ability to preemptively detect dangerous situations.
We film a site for a month and find a pattern to determine unsafe conditions based on the camera's 14 algorithms. There are 6 more categories for various industries. The system can detect and send warning signs to the administrators, allowing a swift response.
The SVMS uses a facial recognition program for intruders or to locate a particular person in a designated area. By calculating the speed and angle of movements, the system can detect violent acts or someone has lost consciousness. It can also figure out if barrels containing hazardous material are in danger of tipping over by calculating their angle. This system changes the dynamics of CCTVs, merely used for recording stuff that has already happened. It's also a major improvement as it cuts down on human error. Previously, an administrator had to monitor multiple screens at all times. And the success rate of detecting an accident drops by around half if a person monitors multiple screens for more than 10 minutes. The rate drops even more drastically after just 20 minutes. Due to this, the government is investing $6.3 million over the next 5 years on these smart surveillance systems. And to address concerns about privacy, security companies have come up with features to protect identities of those caught on camera. Samsung S1 blurs the faces when they're filming and reveals them only when they're legally required to do so. There are an estimated 2.7 million CCTV cameras currently installed in Korea, including those managed by government agencies and those owned by individuals. Kim Ji-yeon, Arirang News.